What's up, my creative faces? L up on set from Creative Sound. We're going to dive in this video and talk about the IO Station 24C by Personas. This was something that was released in NAMM 2020. And yeah, I'm just now getting to it because you guys been asking me what is my thoughts about it. So I'm going to give you my thoughts. So let's dive in. So let's look at it. Now, Personas is known for releasing a lot of products, a lot of hardware that is, and their goal is to make devices that's easy and intuitive. And I'll say lately they've been trying very hard to make things easier for a Studio One users, which is pretty cool and I dig it. Okay, so the Fadeport was probably the first device that take control of Studio One in regards to the knobs and the faders and the different buttons, you know, doing a bunch of things around Studio One. Then the Atom came out, which was pretty cool. I didn't like it. I still have my selfish thoughts about it, but it controls Studio One well, it does a pretty good job. Even though I didn't care for the form factor of the Atom pad, I've always told you guys that it's pretty sweet if you using Studio One solely and that's all you're using. So the pads and the different ways you can control Studio One, it's all integrated in the Atom pad, which is pretty dope. Now let's dive into the IO Station 24C. You guys asked for my thoughts. So I actually think this is pretty cool. It actually takes on the design of the Fadeport. The cool thing about this is that it took a strip of the Fadeport and put it in a small form factor, just like the original Fadeports. But now you have a little bit more control with this thing. And the thing I like about this is that it comes with, let's take a look at this picture here. It's pretty cool. It's like your all-in-one design, and it eliminates the use of interfaces and maybe mixers depending on who you are. I think it fits me for what I'm trying to do. You can use this scroll wheel back and forth. You can switch them back and forth depending on what you're doing, like if you're using automation in your music. But you have your one knob, your one fader, right? You can control the input for your mic or line level. So you have two mic pre's on here, as you can see down here at the bottom. And you have your two outputs. You have a headphone jack, your foot switch, and this is supposed to activate your record button, say like you're a guitarist or anything like that, and you wanted to, and this probably works well for like performances if you're someone. I wonder if you can reassign the foot switch to anything, and I would say you probably could. You got your power on and off, you got your AC jack here, and then you have your USB-C 3 port here, and I saw that it supports USB-C 3 if you have a computer that supports this, and that also have a cable in there that will be shipped with the unit that also supports USB-A. So you guys won't be left out if you guys still working with computers that don't have this connection. So that is pretty cool. I like that concept. And if we go back up here, you have your basic functions, you know, your solo, your mute, your arm, shift, which activates second functions on these different buttons. And you can bypass, you can touch right. This is your automation lane right here. The previous and next knob, it has nice little functions, like you can toggle between your different markers or your arrangement pages or whatever. And it is also your undo and redo buttons here. And this link button is pretty unique. I like it. The way that they explained it is that if you hover over anything inside of Studio One, you can go ahead and lock it in. Like you don't even have to go the extra route of trying to like set automation, like link it to something. This is what this is, this link lock button here. All you gotta do is hover and hit the button and it takes over. Like I think that's pretty cool. I like that concept. And then other things, a pan channel. So depending on the the button you're selected, this is how these buttons work. So if you on a channel, then you can, like, you know, hit the previous and it'll go channel by channel or whatever. If you want the knob to scroll, you know, that's is if you click there. And then, you know, your master click, section, marker, and then your basic navigation function, your stop, your loop or cycle, forward, rewind, record, play, or pause. So and this button right here, I hear that this button is that special button. This is a pretty cool button for, I say it works for guys like me. If you're a mix engineer and you're in a session and you want to quickly mute the button, this was something that was on the Studio 192, the full rack mount. I don't have that capability because I have the mobile version here, but the full rack mount has the actual mute button, if I'm not mistaken. So, you know, this is pretty cool, and this, I can see how this will work inside of the UC Surface, the universal control software that syncs up everything in regards to, like, the mixer or your DSP chip technology in that thing, which is what I'm using right now to record this video. Overall, I think this thing is pretty cool. Also, when you buy it, they make it pretty sweet. You get the Studio Magic, and the Studio Magic is pretty much a bunch of plugins, like your vintage plugins. You get some instruments that goes with this, and yeah, I mean, it kind of makes it worth your while to purchase this if this is something you're interested in. Like I say, it's like a mini mixer with an interface built in, and it controls Studio One, you know, simple basic functions. For me, the way that I use Studio One music production, I mix, master, that type deal, I think that this will work for someone like me. Something real small, compact, something that can actually fit on my desk, right? I have the Fetaport 16, no, the Fetaport 8, and I just find it to be very bulky, you know, for my setup and what I'm using it for. I'm locked into the box way, the, you know, production in the box, mixing in the box type deal. So I find myself always touching the knobs on the screen using my mouse, and I'm fine with that. That's how I've been doing things for so long, and I think something like this would be pretty cool. I wouldn't necessarily use this knob or this fader to mix a song. I'll be using this fader to do simple stuff like automation, or I may use it to, like, turn up and down a channel here and there. But I feel like this fader has so many, like, it's unlimited ways I can use this, or how I can link it to certain parameters in a certain plugin. You know, that's how I would use this fader here, and then vice versa with the knob here. I think it's pretty cool how this thing can be totally customized, because that's how they design it. And also the shift button is what allow you those second functions on here. So that means even here, they say that they give you four customizable functions. So if I hit the shift button, I can click here, here, and here, and assign those to whatever, to do whatever I need to do. So, I mean, this is a pretty cool unit. You know, as you can see the pictures on screen, like how you would use this, you know, great for people who's podcasting, and is really great for people like me, actually, for what I do, YouTube content creator. This is very simple. I like it. Can you use this with other DAWs besides Studio One? Yes, you can, because they support Huey and I believe MCU, but don't quote me. I'm looking at where it says Huey. I'm not sure if that's all that it supports, and if it supports anything else, I'm not really sure, but they're definitely marketing it towards Studio One users, of course, but you can use this if you using Pro Tools. See right here where it says streamline workflow, also supports Mackie control and Huey protocols, make it fast and easy to control Pro Tools, Logic Pro X, Cubase, Ableton Live, and more. So the video that I've seen, it has special support to the DAWs that are listed right here, but it supports all DAWs pretty much. As long as it can read the Huey protocol, then you should be fine. So who is this unit for? I think it's for everybody, advanced and beginners, because sometimes we like to be able to plug in something and it just work, you know, take out the thought and not worry about having to do this and route this and do this blah 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 and make sure this connected. This thing right here is like a all-in-one solution, and it's like press play and it works. I actually like that idea a whole lot better. So before this unit came out, you know, you have your interface, right? I spoke of that earlier. And then you have your mixer, control surface, or whatever. And then usually it was hitting, you know, a bunch of commands on your keyboard in order to get the record function working, stop, rewind, go in, blah, blah, blah. I mean, you still have to use your keyboard and your mouse to edit and things like that. But this thing, I feel like it actually changes the game in a sense, because you don't have to spend a bunch of money to get a decent interface to record your vocal. And this thing also controls your DAW, and it also takes on the animation field, and like you can use it to mix. I mean, I wouldn't just one fader knob, but I mean, you could definitely use it for that purpose. It controls Studio One. As of this video, I'm actually really digging this unit. I didn't really dive into it as much, but you guys kept asking me like, what you think. So now at this point, I'm like, okay, I probably need to put my hands on this because this is pretty cool. So anyway, that's all I have for you guys. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, share the video. I appreciate that as well. Again, this is Ellup from Creative Sound. Remember, music is art, you the artist. Paint your picture. Stay creative without rules.